I'm Colin, welcome to Learn Somatics. Today I want to show you two more variations on a movement we did previously called arch and curl, which involved the elbows coming together and curling up from a lying back position. So I'm going to show you two variations on that. So if you enjoyed that movement, you'll probably like these variations as well. Working position for arch and curl variations is as usual, lying back, legs bent, feet flat on the table. Okay, so the first variation we're going to do is called lateral or same side arch and curl. So we're going to do this on the left side first, and that's facing the camera. What you're going to do is you're going to take your left hand, put it behind your head, like so. And from here, I want you to just pick up your knee, let your lower leg be floppy, so don't have your legs sort of foot up in the air like that, where you're activating your quad a lot, just let it hang. So that lower leg is floppy. Knee is sort of gently above the body, just held above the body. Take your hand, place it on the knee. Now from here, just want you to begin to arch your back. Just see what happens. When you arch your back, it tends to send your knee away like that. So it's just as I arch, the knee goes that way. And I'm holding on to it, so I can't arch as much as I probably normally could. But I just want to feel what happens. So as I arch, the knee goes away. And as I relax, the knee comes back. As I arch, the knee goes away. And as I relax, the knee can come back and I can actually draw it back. And as the back flattens, draw it back even more. So arch, the knee goes away. Flatten, the knee can come toward me, toward my chest. Arch, the knee goes away. Flatten, the knee can be drawn towards my chest. Okay, now the top half, similar to all the previous arch and curl, we're gonna turn the elbow in and tuck the chin, so we lift the head. So from here, there's quite a bit of distance between my knee and my elbow. And from here, just come down. We're gonna see if we can decrease that distance. So how do I get my elbow to come closer to my knee? And now, it's not the goal isn't to touch your elbow off your knee. It doesn't really matter, it's just the vector. But if you do this correctly, you're gonna be able to get a lot closer than you thought. So, elbow comes up, tuck the chin, draw the knee in. Now from here, if I press my back down into the table, boom, all right, I'm almost at my knee, or I'm at my knee, and then slowly down. I didn't have to pull on my leg, I didn't have to pull on my head, I folded in my trunk to bring my knee and elbow together. So try that again, elbow comes up, tuck the chin, knee is drawn in, to just to the point that's comfortable, and now if I press my back down, I fold my trunk, I round my back. Now it's very easy to get the knee and the elbow close together. And then slowly relax down. And again, the goal isn't to touch the knee or elbow off the knee. The goal is to release the front and back on one side. So let's add an arch to the start of this. So I'm going to arch, sending the knee away. Head goes back, elbow goes back. From here I'm going to release. Back is relaxed, elbow comes up, chin tucks, draw the knee in, round the back to bring them forward, and now I'm lengthening out the left side of my back. And when I come down, I'm releasing the left side of my abdominals. Very efficient way of doing things. Coordinating front and back, and contracting and releasing the muscles. Arch, sends the knee away, head back, elbow back, slowly release. Draw the knee in a little bit, tuck the chin, elbow in, round the back to bring the elbow and knee closer and also to lengthen the back on that left side. Slowly down. Last time, arch, send the knee away, press the head back, slowly release, elbow in, tuck the chin, round the back to lengthen the back. So pressing the back into the table helps the back lengthen. And then we can slowly release out. Head comes back, elbow comes back. You can let your foot come down. And from here, you can just lay it flat. And again, you want to check in and see what you've got. Now, I have a regular practice, and from doing that, even I can feel a quite marked difference down that left side of my body. Left side of the trunk feels longer. You should feel something similar yourself. Okay, at same side arch and curl. Now, slide the feet back to standing. You're gonna make one change and you're gonna be able to do the other movement now. You're still gonna have the left hand. You're still gonna have the left hand behind the head, but this time you're gonna take your right knee, okay? And you're gonna do the same thing you did on the other side. Lower leg is floppy, it's nice and relaxed, the foot's relaxed, and you're just taking hold of that knee. Same thing, when we arch, it sends the knee away, and when we flatten, we're able to bring the knee a little closer to us because the back is flattening. It's the flattening, the arching of the back sends the knee away, the flattening of the back allows the knee to come closer to us. Okay, so let's do the top half. Same again, elbow comes in, tuck the chin, and this time we're just going across the body. So we're pressing the back into the table and moving in the direction towards the knee, and then slowly back out. This is diagonal arch and curl, or cross lateral arch and curl. So let's add the arch. We're going to arch, send the knee away, head back, elbow back, hold, we're getting a contraction on the back on the diagonal, and then we're slowly releasing, draw the knee in a little, tuck the chin, sorry, elbow up, tuck the chin, and then if we press the back into the table, then we can come up easily, and then slowly relaxing out. Keep it, just keep a hold of the knee until you're finished. Okay, so we're gonna do this one more time. Arch the back, sends the knee away, press the head back, press the elbow back, just gently. So we feel a contraction in the back, slowly release, draw the knee in a little, elbow up, tuck the chin, and press the back down to curl on the diagonal towards your knee. And from there, slowly relax. Let the knee come down, and you can see how that feels. And again, it's going to feel, you're going to feel asymmetrical now because you've kind of done one arm the whole time, but a little bit less asymmetrical because you've gone left elbow to left knee and then left elbow to right knee. Let's real briefly do the other side. And the legs. So we're going to go right elbow to right knee. Right hand is behind the head. Right knee is up. Just take a hold of that knee. Remember, the leg is floppy. Okay. As we arch, sends the knee away. As we let the back relax and flatten, the knee can come in. Elbow up. Tuck the chin. Press the back down to curl up. Slowly relax back out. Arch the back. Slowly release, elbow up, tuck the chin, back presses down to curl up. So pressing the back down enables us to use our trunk to curl forward, and then it gets very easy. And then slowly down, back out. One more time, arch, head back, elbow back, slowly release, elbow up, tuck the chin, draw the knee in to wherever's comfortable, and then round the back into the table, and that allows you to get a good curl, and then slow release. Okay. Lateral arch and curl on the right side. Now all we have to do is switch legs, and we're set up to do our diagonal arch and curl on the other side. Again, we can arch, send the knee away, exhale, let the back flatten, draw the knee in, elbow up, tuck the chin, press the back down to close the distance. And slowly release. And you might find on one side you can go closer or further to the knee. It doesn't matter, it'll even out as you practice. Arch away, slowly release, draw the knee in, elbow up, tuck the chin, round the back. And I can feel I'm a little tighter on this side today. No big deal. Slowly out, and back down. And just do one more, real low effort, make it lazy. Arch, send the knee away, head back, elbow back, slowly release, and draw the knee in, tuck the chin, elbow up and round the back, press the back down to curl up on the diagonal, and slowly release. Now you can lay it flat. You've done both sides and both diagonals. And you can see how that feels. That's lateral arching curl and diagonal arching curl. Give them a try and let me know how you get on.